All right, friends, so check it out. Here's what's going to happen. As we know, we have our little Aruba switch right here. We're just going to focus on 5 interfaces. So this will be interface 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we also have our 5 PCs out on the network. And those PCs are connected via Ethernet cables. Now, the IP addressing that I'm going to use is going to be within the range 192.168.10.1. Or 10.0/24. The first PC I will configure as .1, next .2, all the way to 3, 4, and 5. And all we're going to do in this particular video is we're going to effectively wake up the default VLAN of VLAN 1 on the switch by placing each of the interfaces into that particular VLAN, and then we'll do some testing and see how things actually shake out once everything is configured. So that's the basic plan of attack. Let's go to our topology then and make it a reality. Alrighty-o, so here we have our 5 PCs and our switch. So the first thing I will do is go to PC number 1. Even though it does say VPC2, this is going to be PC number 1, so let's open this up. Alright, so here is the first one. If I say show IP, we should see the IP address configuration. As we can see, there is a default of pretty much nothing on it. So let's go and change that then. I will just say IP, and it's going to be 192.168.10.1, and we'll make it /24 if I hit enter. Give it a moment to configure, and now if I just say show IP, there we go right there. So let's just repeat the process then. Close you down, go into number 2 right here. Again, so PC number 2, as we can see, show IP will not have any configurations. Let's make that change right now. So IP will be 192.168.10.2/24. We check for any duplicate addressing, make sure it is unique. It is, so it has been accepted. Let's do a show IP. The configuration is now there. Close you down, slide on over to PC number 3. Again, let's just check the configuration. Nothing is on it quite just yet. We'll just say IP 192.168.10.3/24. There is the configuration. Just arrow up to confirm. There we go right there. And let's just quickly do the last two right here, okay? Okay, so this one here, show IP, nothing on it. IP 192.168.10.4/24. There we go. Show IP. There is the configuration. And the last one we'll go to here. Just open this up. Show IP. Nothing is right there. We'll do 192.168. And this will be 10.5. So as we can see here, everyone within the same network range. Oh, I forgot to do the command IP beforehand. Try that again. There we go. Let's just verify with the show IP. There it is right there. So like I said, all of them within the same IP address range. However, we're going to have to do some basic configurations to get things up and running. For example, if I try to ping the other IP addresses, so let's maybe go with ping 192.168. Let's try 10.1. Right now, as it stands, it's not going to be reachable. Now, the first thing we are going to have to do is to go to the switch right here. So we go to the switch. If I type in the command show IP interface brief and I hit enter, if I scroll all the way up to the very top right here, we're going to see that each interface is in the down state. See that? 1-1, all of these here, down. Now, watch this. Let me just go into each of these interfaces. So interface 111, and I'll say no shutdown. Okay, looks good. Let's exit out, arrow up. Let's go into interface number 2. Let's follow the same process. We'll say no shutdown, exit back out. Into number 3, bring that up to, exit back out. Into 4, no shutdown it. Let's exit back out. And lastly, go into number 5, and then no shutdown. Now watch this, okay? Just exit, exit. Let's run the same command again. It's show IP interface brief. Hit enter, scroll on up. Okie doke, so we can see these interfaces are now in the up state all the way from number 1 to number 5. Now just watch this for a moment. Despite being in the up state, if I say show VLAN, notice we still have the default VLAN in the down state. We have no member ports, and we can see here no interfaces are belonging to that particular VLAN. Now the thing here though is, let's just check this command. If I just say show interfaces brief, so that's not show IP interfaces brief, that's just show interface brief. If I now hit enter, look at the information we get. Let's just scroll all the way up to the top, and we can see here we have our 5 interfaces. Now they happen to be in the enabled and up state, but look at the mode that they're in. They're in routed mode. See this? What this means is that by default, the interfaces are not acting like regular layer 2 interfaces. They're acting like layer 3 interfaces that should actually have IP addresses configured on the ends of them. Now, because of this, these interfaces are not automatically getting thrown into the default VLAN. So watch this, okay? Let's go back to the first interface. I'll say configure terminal, and we'll go into interface 1/1/1. And what I will do here is I will just say no routing, okay? That's going to change this interface from layer 3 to be layer 2. So if I just exit back out for a moment, and again, and let's just run this command of show interface brief and just check how things have changed for that particular interface. Look at this right here. See this? Interface 1 is no longer in the routed mode. It's in what is known as access mode. And automatically, look at this, it has joined that default VLAN. So there happened to be one very particular thing that we had to account for with this Aruba switch, and that was having to ensure that the actual interfaces themselves have been configured as layer 2 interfaces. They're not regular layer 3 routing interfaces. Now, once we have done that, the automatic membership of the default VLAN is now going to kick into play. So watch this, okay? If I just do the same type of thing, let's go into, let's say, number 2. So configure terminal, interface 1/1/2, and just do the same process. We'll say no routing here. If I hit enter, go back out, and again, run our command to confirm. Scroll all the way up to the top. We can see here once again, this interface has followed suit. It's also in what is known as access mode. We'll talk about that more in a little bit. And we can see it's joined VLAN 1. So as it stands, the devices attached to interface 1 and interface 2 are in the same network range, that is the 192.168.10.0/24 range, and they are both within the same VLAN, so they should be in the same layer 2 broadcast domain. Let's now see if PC1 can ping PC number 2, okay? So we're going to PC1 right here. So again, if we just do our show IP, we can see our IP address. Let's just try to ping ourselves. So we ping 10.1, we can see we have no problems at all. If I arrow up and try to ping, let's go with PC number 5, not going to be reachable. However, PC number 2, if we try this and hit enter, we actually do have connectivity because they're within the same VLAN and they're in the same IP network. So let's just quickly go and make the modification for the other devices, okay? So back to the switch, we'll just say configure terminal to make a configuration change. We'll go into interface 113, just say no routing. Let's exit back out, go into interface number 4, no routing, and then lastly, exiting back out. And finally, let's go into interface number 5, no routing. And if we just exit and exit again, we do our final confirmation check, scroll all the way up to the top. Now we can see all five devices, or five devices, now we can see all five interfaces are within VLAN 1 in access mode. So if we now try to ping, so here we are back on PC number 1. First time we tried to ping PC number 5, it was not reachable. Let's now try it. If we hit enter, we do have connectivity. Same again for PC number 4, as well as PC number 3. And by the way, for clarity, just to prove this, if we go into the third one right here, here's the IP address. From PC number 3, can we ping, let's say, PC number 4? So we'll ping 10.4. Absolutely we can. And this will be true for all of the devices within the network. So if we go back to the switch and I type the command show VLAN, look at this right here. We can see the default VLAN is now in the status of up. And the interfaces we can see that belong to that particular VLAN, look at this right here, see that hyphen? That denotes a little range. So basically from interfaces 111 all the way to 115, every single one of them belong in that VLAN. Now also, if we type the command show MAC address table and to enter, look at this right here, we actually see the ports that we have, i.e. the interfaces. We see the associated MAC addresses on the end of that interface. So these are the MAC addresses of each of the PCs. And we can actually see the VLAN membership also with this particular command. See this? Each one belonging to VLAN number 1. Therefore, they're all within the same layer 2 broadcast domain.
Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a career in IT or just looking to brush up your IT skills, then be sure to visit cbtnuggets.com for a free trial.